Hey, how's it going, guys? Mr. Boss for the win here, and in today's GTA 5 video, we're going to be taking a look at the inflation prices of vehicles and cars over the last, really, 6 or 7 years, all the way back in 2013 to today in 2020. And this is something that a lot of people have obviously recognized how expensive the new cars and vehicles are in Grand Theft Auto Online, but it didn't always used to be this way. So I don't know how many of you guys that are watching this video were playing Grand Theft Auto Online back in 2013, 2014. I mean, the first update, all the vehicles were free. Like, you didn't have to buy any of them. And obviously, we know today that that's not the case at all. But even after that first update, the vehicles weren't terribly expensive. So today, what I wanted to do is look at a couple of examples of vehicles in the same car family where we see a huge increase in price over the years for essentially buying the same model. So let's start to dive into it. And let's begin with the newest vehicle that Rockstar has introduced, because it's probably the freshest on your mind. And that is the Karen Sultan Classic, which you can buy now for $1,718,000. Or if you happen to get the trade price, it's $1,288,500. And this is significantly more expensive than the original Sultan that was added back in 2013. And even the RS version that you could upgrade at Benny's in 2016. So in 2013, you could get the Sultan for free off the street, or what you could actually do is buy it off of Benny's site for $12,000 if you wanted to, making it one of the cheapest cars in the game. And if you wanted to upgrade this to the RS supercar version at Benny's, it would only cost you $795,000. So you guys can see, from 2013 to 2020, this same Sultan, although be it different versions of it, has gone from $12,000 to $1,718,000. And we'll talk about why this might be the case, especially for certain vehicles that might be a retro or classic variant, but still, to go from $12,000 to $1.7 million, that's pretty extreme. So that's just our first example right there. Our next example is going to be the Fister Comet, which has seemingly had a ton of different versions added into the game. So as a part of the Doomsday heist, they added two new Comets. The first was the Comet SR for $1,145,000, and also another Comet, the Comet Safari, for $710,000. Those were added in the same update. So pretty expensive vehicles, and it gets even more expensive when you realize the original Comet is available for $100,000. So although it's not as bad as the Karen Sultan family, it still is a pretty big price bump to go from $100,000 to $700,000 to $1.1 million, basically for the same vehicle with just a different shape and design. And there's also a Benny's version of the Comet that we didn't even really look at today. It has a conversion price of $645,000, so essentially on the same line as the Comet Safari, about 6 to 7 times more expensive than the original. So again, you can see the inflation rate from the original one to the ones added in 2016 and 2019 and 2020. So that's the Comet. What about one of the other recently added vehicles? Let's take a look at the Debace JB700, which was added on day one for $350,000, as you guys can see there. And then recently, Rockstar added the Debace JB700W for $1.47 million, which is essentially the same car with working machine guns. That's literally it. The customization is the same. There's no differences. In fact, the only thing you can do is like either remove the machine guns or have them on there and have them actually work. So again, really weird things that Rockstar have seemingly done to the same vehicles over the years. Now, this vehicle hasn't been released yet, but it will over the next couple of weeks or months, depending on how long Rockstar stretch out the drip feed. But that is another version of the Dinka Blista. So the one we have in the game right now is the Blista Compact, which I can actually get for free. But if you can't, it's only $42,000, so really not all that expensive at all. And the Dinka Blista Kanjo, which is going to be added again in a couple of weeks, it has a buy it now price of $580,000 or a trade price of $435,000. So it's almost 10 times more expensive if you get the trade price. It's about 11 or 12 times more expensive if you have the regular buy it now price for it. That is wild. And remember, that vehicle was available in day one. This one, again, will be coming out in 2020, sometime in the next couple of weeks. You can't forget about motorcycles. What about the Principe Faggio? You guys can see there that this has been available since day one for a measly $5,000, so hardly anything at all. And then the biker update variants that were introduced, the Pagassi Faggio Sport, $47,500, so it's almost 10 times as expensive from the original variant. And then the Faggio Mod, which is $55,000, which is basically right at 11 times more expensive than the original variant. So again, even though it might not seem like that big of a deal, $5,000 to $55,000, the amount that it increases is still pretty much the same as a lot of the other things we've seen. It usually gets around 10 to 15 times more expensive. So that's another example right there. What about a handful of other cars? We're going to just go kind of back to back here. You've got the Übermach Zion for $60,000, the Sentinel XS for $60,000, and the Übermach Zion Cabrio for $65,000. So keep in mind all of those vehicles right there. And I guess you could even throw in the Sentinel convertible for $95,000 if you really wanted to. What about their modern day additions to the game? How do those stack up? Well, look at the Übermach Sentinel Classic here. It is $650,000 if you were to buy it now. And if you wanted it for the trade price, $487,500. Again, roughly 10 to 15 times more expensive than the original variants that were added. And even if we take a look at the Übermach Zion Classic, this one breaks the mold a little bit more because it's like 20 times more expensive, $812,000 compared to what, like $65,000 for the original. So that one for me was wild. That was probably like one of the biggest jumps that I saw from the original variants in the Zion Classic. What about the Weenie Issy? That's right, the Weenie Issy was available to purchase on day one for $18,000, so not all that expensive at all. And it's had a handful of variants added over the years. The first was the Weenie Issy Sport from the Diamond Casino and Resort update. Almost $900,000. $900,000 versus $18,000. Is that a little bit wild or what? And we're not done there. Remember the Southern San Andreas Super Sports Series update? The Weenie Issy Classic was available for $360,000 or $270,000 if you had the buy it now price, or the trade price, I should say. So that one's not as terrible, but it's still a pretty big jump from $18,000. And there's a handful of other examples as well. Like, for example, the Vapid Dominator. So you can actually buy this for $35,000 or $26,250 if you have the trade price. And also take a look at the Bravado Gauntlet there as well. We'll sort of go two for one here. That's only $32,000. So both of those muscle cars, not expensive at all. And if we take a look at the Bravado Gauntlet Classic, it's $615,000 to buy it now, $461,250 for the trade price. And if you want the Gauntlet Hellfire, it's $745,000. Luckily, it's on sale right now, which makes it a little bit cheaper. But that's wild. Again, almost 15 to 20 times more than the original variant. And what about the Dominator? The Dominator GTX is $725,000, essentially making it the same percentage increase as the Bravado Gauntlet Hellfire was. So that right there is absolutely wild. So those are just some examples right there, and I'm sure there's a handful of others that you could actually reference, and that's sort of something we'll talk about as I'm showing you some of those examples right now, is maybe why Rockstar have decided to do this. And I think I have a couple of different reasons. Number one, the first is that Rockstar have given us, at least in their eyes, more ways to make money. In 2013, the only way to really make money was like contact missions and robbing stores and maybe selling cars and stuff like that. That was it. So because of that, they couldn't make vehicles incredibly expensive. I mean, other than buying a shark card. Now we have heists, multiple forms of them. We have, you know, a handful of different businesses, tons of ways to make money. So I can understand that, you know, because we now have more ways to make money, Rockstar can make things more expensive. Another reason I could see the price increases is a lot of the new vehicles that were added are either retro or classic versions, which that is true to a degree. A lot of cars in real life that were older or maybe produced in the 60s, 70s, 80s have now appreciated in value in current time, which makes them more expensive. But not every car is like that, and not every car appreciates to 10 times the value of the modern one. So that example doesn't work for every single car. And you could even look at it the opposite way, like some of the vehicles that they've added, like the Dominator GTX is like the new version of the Dominator. So you would expect it to be a little bit more expensive, but you know, 20 times more expensive, I'm not so sure about that. Now, one thing I wanted to avoid in this video was comparing vehicles that had weaponized upgrades, with the exception of the JB700, because I thought that one was ridiculous. So for example, like the Coil Voltic is originally $150,000. The Impante Ruiner is $10,000. I didn't want to compare them to their Rocket Voltic and Ruiner 2000 variant, because Rockstar has like weird rules when it comes to pop culture references and putting weapons on the cars. So that's something I didn't really want to dive into. That has a ridiculous amount of inflation altogether. But that right there should just give you a couple of examples of how crazy the prices have changed over the years in Grand Theft Auto Online. So I'd love to hear from you guys in the comments down below. What do you think of the price increase of vehicles in Grand Theft Auto Online from 2013 to 2020? Let me know your thoughts, opinions, and more in the comments down below. I'd love to hear from you guys down there. If you guys did go on to enjoy this video, though, a like rating would, of course, be awesome. And be sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel if you are new, or you want to stay up to date on all the latest GTA and Red Dead Redemption videos that I'm doing here on my channel. And be sure to ring that notification bell as well. Sometimes YouTube just doesn't work, and if you ring that bell, you'll always be guaranteed to be notified when new videos arrive. But of course, as always, guys, thank you all so much for watching. Take care, and I'll see you guys in the next video.